Hello everyone, and welcome to More to Explore. I'm Miss Natasha, and today we will be creating watercolor sea bookmarks. Okay, in your kit you will find a pre-cut cardstock size of a bookmark. You will find a sea animal bead. You will find pre-cut yarn, and you will find various colors of paint. What's not in your kit but you will still need is a cup for warm water, a paintbrush, tissues, a hole puncher, and scissors. Okay, the first step would be to take your tissue and open it up, and you want to use it like a placemat. So if you look at the one I made, I use the tissue as a placemat so it can collect all that extra paint and keep my table clean. And then you want to take your cardstock bookmark and you want to take your paints. Another tissue to lay your paintbrush on, and of course your paintbrush. And now you can get started. So go ahead and paint what you would like to paint on your bookmark. I did give you some inspiration, printed out you some ocean life, so you can always follow that. Otherwise, I'll show you how I made this one. Okay, for watercolor, what you want to do is you want to take a little bit of the paint and you want to dip it in the water, and then you're going to move it around as much as you can. And you're just going to keep repeating that process until you cover as much as you'd like. Now for the ocean, I did try to mix a lot of the water with it to give it that watercolor effect. But what you can also do is you can mix the other blue color into the water and see how it gives that nice dimension. So you can do it with both blues, and go ahead and cover as much as the ocean that you want to cover. All right, then we'll move on to the next part. So if you notice here at the bottom of the ocean, I'm making it darker by just using the dark blue paint and not mixing as much water with it. That way it looks heavier and it looks darker. And that's what you want at the bottom of the ocean. So here's what I got so far. So this will be the ocean part. And now we are going to do the sky. And the sky is just your light blue. So just use the light blue on the sky. So with the sky, I'll take my light blue, I'll mix it with water, very similar to the ocean. swatch paint there. Maybe it'll be a stormy sky. Okay, and then for your ship, you want to do just the dark blue, so it looks like a silhouette in the distance. And for the ship, you're going to make the main portion at the bottom and then your two masts. So you can always pause the video on this and then draw it, paint it. Remember, no water, just the dark blue paint. So now I'm going to do my two masts with my sails, two sails on each mast. That way it looks big, big ship. And you can always make your ship even bigger. If you want to put more masts and more sails, by all means, you can make it a huge ship. I think I might just do that. I think I might make it a little bit bigger. Alright, and for the next step, we're going to make the bottom portion, the sandy portion, and that's going to use whatever you want, but I like to use reds, orange, and yellow. So let's go ahead and do that. For this, we will use the water for the watercolor effect. We'll mix it in there. If you want to speckle it too, like how sand is kind of speckled, and dirt, and soil, and all those things. So you can just dip and dab, and it'll look more like the ocean bottom. And you can do that with yellows, oranges, reds, it'll all work. So this is what we have so far, and you may be thinking, wow, that looks a little funny, but don't worry, because we're going to add ocean sea vegetation, like seaweed, and so it'll just look so smooth once that seaweed's on. So go ahead and take green with your water for the watercolor effect, and then you're going to just take it and pull it. So add it to the bottom. Like that. It's perfect. It's almost like it belongs there now. So that's your transition from your sand to your ocean. Seaweed works perfectly. Now, if you would like to make these, I guess, ocean ridges, cliffs, you're going to do it very similarly to the sand. except we're going to use more water for a stronger watercolor effect. We're going to use more red. And then you can put the orange and the yellow inside. But you definitely want it a little bit darker, so I think I'm gonna go more red. Probably use my napkin to change the color, the water. Get more of that red in there. So once you're happy with that, you can start on the other side. See if I'm happy with that. Yeah, I think that looks okay. So I'll take that off my paintbrush. Okay, so now we're gonna do some sea life. So we're gonna take, I have a little magenta here, but you can use whatever you want. Whatever color. I'm gonna use that to make the coral on top of my little ledge or cliff. And then I really want to make jellyfish too in the center. So I'm going to do kind of like an oval, and I'm just going to circle it. So again, I use the paint, I use the water. You definitely want a lot of water with the watercolor effect for the jellyfish, because they're kind of translucent, which means see-through. So the watercolor effect gives you that. And then I'll put his tentacles. And then if you want the outer edge to be a little brighter, so you can tell it's his head, you can border just with the paint. So see how I made my oval? I used the watercolor with the paint, and then I bordered it just with the paint. Gives a beautiful effect. And then tentacles, I'm gonna do paint and watercolor again and pull it, just like I did with my seaweed. So there you are. Now that we're done painting, we are going to let it dry. Always remember, clean your brush, dip it in the water, take the paint off. You don't want the paint dry on your brush. Keep your paintbrush nice and clean. And so, with this, we are going to close our paint so they don't dry out. Is dry, so you can go ahead and use your hole puncher. Perfect. And then what we're going to do is we are going to loop our thread, the pre-cut thread, and you're going to put it through this hole punched hole. And the easiest way to do that is to take your yarn or thread and go ahead and twist it. Twist the end. And you'll see it gets nice and thin. and then it's easy to thread it through. Just like that. And then we're gonna tie a knot. So make sure it's even. Just like that. Go ahead, tie your knot. And then we're gonna put our sea animal bead. So go ahead and grab your bead that you have. So I have a whale. And we're gonna take them all again and we're gonna thread it through our bead. Now you want all the ends to line up perfectly together, and then you're gonna twist them again. So this part might be a little challenging for some people, so you are welcome to grab a guardian and help them help you. And they might need to pinch them all too to get it through your sea animal bead. I'm gonna push it all the way and pull them. Beautiful. And then you're gonna tie one last knot so your sea animal doesn't run away. And you push your knot all the way to your bead, and you are all done. Okay, so go ahead, let your bookmark dry, and when it's completely dried, you can then use it. Even better, if you have a laminator at home, it would be great to just laminate this portion. That way the paint never comes off. But that is entirely up to you. So just let it dry and then you can use your C bookmark. Did you know around 70% of the planet's surface is covered by oceans? In fact, the oceans hold about 96.5% of all water on Earth.